to Music City, live from Liberty Hall at the historic factory in Franklin. Music City Roots is on the air. Tonight, a pioneer of Colorado jam gas grass gone solo. Local purveyor of cosmic southern funk, some enthralling indie pop and blues based songwriter who's toured America's backroads and tattoo parlors. Keeping it real, that's what we do with top artists through from and passing through today's Nashville. Our musical host tonight is a guy who knows Nashville as well as anyone. I mean, this guy writes obituaries like nobody else because he knows everybody. He's been chronolicking this town for almost 20 years, and just this month, he's got a brand new book to show for it, an outstanding book, I might say. Please welcome singer, songwriter, and music historian, my brother, Peter Cooper.
Thank you. Thank you, Mr. Bilbrey. I want to do a song that was written by my son, Baker Cooper.
Yeah, the one you all tried to auction off here one night.
Yeah, he just turned 7, and when he was 6, I was working on writing a song, and he came over to me and said, well, I want to write a song. And I said, okay, what kind of song do you want to write? And he said, I want to write a rock and roll song. I said, okay, well, what's the first line? He said, rock and roll, oh, 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 oh. I said,
that's
okay.
It.
So that works. And then I asked him what the next line would be, and he told me that, and we got to the chorus, and I said, this is the part where you really got to kind of define yourself to your listening audience, and what is it that you want to say about yourself? And he said, I want to say I am the Wolf King.
Wow.
Rock and roll, oh, 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 oh. Rock and roll, oh, 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 oh. Stand on your leg like a flamingo. Stand on your leg like a flamingo. Rock and roll, oh, 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 oh. A zombie, zombie, is as cool as anything. Undead is awesome. How cool is that? A zombie, to the chorus. I am the Wolf King. I like to prowl at night. It makes me feel alright. Are you scared at my sight? My name is Baker. Acre. I'm as cool as a zombie because I am the Wolf King. My name is Baker. Acre. I am the Wolf King. I like to prowl at night. It makes me feel alright. Are you scared at my sight? You should be scared at my side. You better be scared at my side. Stand on your leg like a flamingo. Stand on your leg like a flamingo. Stand on your leg like a flamingo. Or else.
All right. Yeah, good. That was great. I'll be singing that the rest of the night, man.
To those listeners who tuned in just after the explanation, but before the song began, Peter was singing a song by his son, 7-year-old Baker.
That's right.
That's congratulations on the birthday.
Well, thank you. Thank you. Thank you. It's a great book, Craig. Let me tell you. It's just wonderful. Hey, folks. Welcome to Music City Roots. We know you could be enjoying many other forms of entertainment right now, including Manly Men with Sticks, trying to put a period in a basket while people throw catfish at them.
It's a great sport.
I understand it is a hot new game in town. Now, actually, it is a wonderful thing what's happened with the Nashville Predators, who are in the Stanley Cup Finals for the very first time,
yeah.
And we're happy about that. And because a lot of us here have the game on DVR, we will not be giving score updates about the Predators Penguins game. I mean, we might, but if we do, there'll be lies. You know, so we might lie to you about it. We do wish the Preds well. Hey, let's get started on this fantastic show. I want you to meet the guys up here who keep this whole show moving. Over here is our golden-throated radio announcer, the voice of reason in a world gone bonkers. Tennessee Radio Hall of Famer, Keith Bilbrey.
Thank you. Thank you. I like that song. Now, your son does get half credit for that, right? Are you going to give him the whole thing?
He gets full credit.
Oh, cool.
I mean, yeah, those chords have been used before by Chuck Berry ought to deserve
That's
half
right.
credit on that.
But
I
Peter's
like
his publisher, so the, yeah. the kid's already getting hammered in the business. It's
yeah,
terrible.
Absolutely, absolutely. And hey, just in case you didn't know who he was, meet our show journalist and interview guy. He is more into fact-checking than body-checking. He is a writer, not a fighter, Mr. Craig Havockhurst.
Hey, guys. Good evening. Welcome back to Roots on a Wednesday night. Peter's book is called Johnny's Cash and Charlie's Pride, Lasting Legends and Untold Adventures in Country Music. Did I get that right?
You did.
Yeah. I have here a list of some of the titles that were rejected for the book. And I'm glad that, you know, maybe you, I think you made the right call. But there was a chapter about mishaps on the road, tour buses that have to get pulled over, Rascals Flats. That chapter.
I pushed for that.
A book about popular dogs, country stars and their dogs. That was the chapter called Furlan's Husky. Kenny's Chesney was another good chapter, but I understand that you're in long-term litigation with him over a record review from about 2002.
That's right.
So
That's right.
That didn't go. And the other one that didn't make it was Dolly's Boobs. That just didn't go. But
no, I
made the right call, and I can't
she
wait to read it.
She was all for it, yeah.
She was. She always is. Yeah. Folks, we're going to have some killer music coming up, and I'll tell you about the lineup in just a moment. First, I want to say thanks, as I do this time of the show every week, to our pals at Soulshine Pizza, because they make great hot pizza for our crew who come and put this set up and work the sound and make sure that we are all here ready to start on time each week. We appreciate their efforts there, and you can go visit Soulshine in Midtown, Nashville, or down here in Franklin at Berry Farms, and please tell them that we sent you. Also, our folks help us out from Dex Imaging. They provide the equipment that we print on site, those programs that you were given on your way in. And we love providing those and giving the artists a place to take them home, have a souvenir, and remember who you saw here tonight. DexImaging.com is where to go to find out more about that local company that's expanding around the region rapidly. Blackstone Brewery brings the lineup each week, and we're going to be hearing at the end of the night. I'll give you a little caveat about, well, I'll tell you. First of all, welcome the Jeff Austin Band. He's going to be here from Colorado. Jeff Austin Band's here. Jeff, to let you know, has been slammed with laryngitis. No joke. And so we're going to miss the interview, and we will be shuffling things around, but he's going to play a full set. I think he's just pretty much going to rock the instrumentals tonight and jam out. We might have a guest vocalist, but Mr. Jeff's feeling fine, but his voice is shot. So we want to let you know that before we got started. In the third slot, a rock and roll band called Roadkill Ghost Choir from down in Florida, ready to go. Give them a round of applause, folks. We'd like to. They're back there. They're sensitive artists. They need affirmation. And up in the second set, from right here around Middle Tennessee, the Natchez Tracers. Yeah. Opening the show. Well, Peter Cooper will tell you about that.
I sure will, but first I can't resist giving a hockey update. The Predators are actually up now 6-0 with 28 seconds gone in the first period. So it's going totally great. Y'all, this person sitting next to me on stage dedicated himself to the Blues early in life with total immersion. His travels, his day jobs, his hard work on the craft have all led him here today with a superb album, Sunnyside, and a reputation for music that is both deep and authentic. Please welcome to our stage, Jake Labonte. Thank you, Jake.
You come around with the crying, can't stop lying about where you've been. Same old story, same old mess. You're a damsel in distress. I ain't the hero you've been looking for. I ain't even got a cape no more. So take that salt to a new address. Poor damsel in distress. Hold them secrets till the day you die. You cry and cry till the salt runs dry. You come round with the cry. You come round with the crying. Tears coming down like the wall in Berlin, but you ain't ever free, you're always oppressed. You're a damsel in distress, you wear a tight face when you meet the crowd. So well made, it's so high-browed, but there ain't no prize underneath that dress. Just a damsel in distress, hold them secrets till the day you die. You cry and cry till the salt runs dry. You come round with the crying. Accompanied by a broken violin, a tiny truth you wanted to confess. You're a damsel in distress, you got a new fool to pay your premium, to say your prayer till the next chump come. But he's no prince, you're no princess. Just a damsel in distress, hold them secrets till the day you die. You cry and cry till the salt runs dry. You come round with the crying, with the cry, with the cry, with the cry. You cry and cry till the salt runs dry.
Thank you very much. All right, gonna play you a few songs off of this new album. This is a song called The Hotel. The hotel stands in disrepair. The tenants, they don't seem to care. Rent is cheap and the bulbs are bare. Good light for playing solitaire. The bar is open down below. Beer is flat, but the beer is cold. Good enough for rock and roll. Good enough to violate parole. Put the box in pawn again. Homie, where'd you get the blue skin? Got a monkey like a Siamese twin. Keeps the walls from closing in. Oh, oh, fix me now, won't you? Oh, oh, fix me now. I'm in the wrong key. Bathroom is down the hall. Share the creep, share the crawl. Leave a blood stain on the wall. Cleaned up with hypodermosol. Locks changed, ran late. Blew the money on a little weight. Wish that chick would turn another day. Too sick to communicate. Jimmy the door and sneak inside. Still late by 12 feet wide. Just enough room for a man to hide. Unless he's undersupplied. Oh, oh, fix me now, won't you? Fix me. Oh, oh, fix me now. Street, the best balloon, blacker than the bottom of my spoon. Booster radio, get one soon. Run it all again in the afternoon. Cut the deck and deal the press. Pay the boss who lives upstairs. He got no friends and got no cares. Gonna throw me out next time, he swears. Shoebox amidst debris keeps a lid on used to be. Guitar picks and a degree in surviving disharmony. Oh, oh, fix me now, won't you fix me? Oh, oh, fix me now, fix me. Oh, oh, fix me now, won't you fix me? Thank you. We got it worked out. I'll play you another one off of this new record. And if you happen to like it, we have them for the low, low price of $9.99. That's 666 upside down, Satan worshiper. Get thee behind me now. Gold hair like the ring on her hand. Oh, heaven, mercy. Oh, how I wish she was mine. I wish she was. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you, rock and roll fans. A little bit of acoustic solo rock and roll. The music video for that one just came out today. How I Wish You Was Mine. Check that out on your iPhone, tablet, what have you. This is the title track off of the album. This is called Sunnyside. Another gesture from the novelty store. Tragic, really. It's not even silly. Total waste of energy. Thank you very much. I think I got time for one more song, and I got time for two more songs. I don't know that many songs, people. I'm gonna have to backtrack and just take a few lyrics from this one, a few from that one. Let's see what I got here. One really long one. Yeah.
All right.
I'll try out this one here. Thank you. Now I got time for three quarters of a song. This is the tiniest song I know. This is a song called Tiny. This is one of my songs. It's in the last Rambo movie for your Rambo fans out there. This is not a joke. I do play a singing mercenary in the last Rambo movie. If you saw the last one, we're going down a boat in Burma, and I sing this song. This is called Tiny. Digging a well with no blood stain, poking it around with the blind man's cane. That's when Tiny came up on the scene. He fell in my well like a tiny drop of rain. He waved to me and I hunkered low. I saw some tiny things I'd never seen before. His little voice said, let's get down tonight. I knew that Tiny was the way, all right. Tiny is the way, Tiny is the way. Tiny is the only way to go now. Let's all get small, go down the well, between the tiny heaven. Time.
can run, he can fly, he can deep sea dive. He's so small he never needs to hide. Can't pin nothing on him and make it stay. Cause Tiny gets smaller every single day. Tiny is the way. Let's all get small, go down the well, between the tiny heaven and the tiny hell. Incredibly small. I really can't read it cause I'm still too tall. It has illustration made by Tiny's hand of prehistoric creatures and mighty men. It tells a story about where Tiny's been. Yes, he always keeps a record of what he's seen. I asked him to tell me who he's keeping it for. He said, when you get tiny, you won't ask no more. Tiny is the way. Let's all get small, go down the well, between the tiny heaven and the tiny hell. Tiny's the way.
Thank you.
Jake Labatt. Look at that. Beautiful. It's something else.
That's good.
Real good. Real good. Man, that thumb, just that steady thumb.
The
steady thumb,
the
thumb of Jake Labatt's.
That's right.
Man, it was hard for me to even pay attention to the hockey stuff.
Yeah, do we have an update?
And there's not, well, they keep throwing... you know, catfish out on the ice and it, whoa, wait a second.
What is that?
I believe that's some
fried chicken.
Puckett's fried chicken that's been thrown onto our stage at us. I guess it was the hockey
throw
jersey.
Throw some more.
Wow. That's some good looking chicken there.
Oh, well, if you'll hurry, the 7-second rule is not over yet.
Having been on this stage a lot, I think I'm gonna. It would be more. Yeah, it is. It's over. It's over. Man, Puckett sure does make some good food.
They
there,
make
Keith
some
Bilbrey.
Awfully good food. Man, that blackberry cobbler today was to die for.
That'll do it. The blackberry cobbler
stuff.
Will do it
yeah.
for you.
And do you know they have a location in Murfreesboro now? They do.
I didn't know that.
I can get off the radio at WMOT, just zip on over to Puckett's and. Eat my fill.
That is, that's great.
They got the money, honey. I got the time, you know?
Well, you'll need some time to get back from Murfreesboro on the,
that's right.
on the highways because it's a little congested there, Keith Bilbrey.
A little bit. Well, congratulations to Puckett's on there. Are you going to eat that chicken or not?
I'm saving it for you, bud.
Okay.
I filled up on that cobbler.
Yeah, I know.
By the way, I should give an update.
Yeah, you really
Keith.
Should. Yeah, six to nothing, you say?
It was 6-0, and then we got a touchdown. So it's 13-0, but the Penguins kicked a field goal.
Uh-huh.
And so now it's 13-3 with 12 minutes and 26 seconds left in the first period.
I see.
And the Predators on the power play.
That's right. Okay. Sound like Pete Weber. Well, we've
I
put
the
Craig Havokhurst in the penalty box, and I'll get to him in a moment. I want to say congratulations to Puckett's on their new location down in the borough. They're on a mission to spread that Southern comfort food all across the state of Tennessee. Find Puckett's locations in Nashville, Franklin, Columbia, Chattanooga, now in Murfreesboro. More information can be found at Puckett's GRO Diamondhall.com. You know, you don't buy a diamond every day. I know you don't, Peter. I don't. You don't buy a diamond every day. But when that special time comes, just remember you've got good friends in the diamond business who just happen to have a product on the cutting edge of the diamond industry. Go to the web, star129.com, to learn why and how the Star 129 was created to literally outshine ordinary diamonds. Take a look at those before and after photos of diamonds that were recut into Star 129s. Absolutely stunning. Now, here in Nashville, the Star 129 is available exclusively at Forster's Diamond Outlet. If you're in the Hickory Hollow neighborhood, stop by and see a live comparison. You will not believe your eyes. Now, if you're not in Nashville, you can find a list of Star 129 dealers around the country at Star129.com. I knew somebody was going to get the chicken before it was over with. Craig Havokhurst, what's going on over in the penalty box? I mean, the chat room.
Nobody ever throws food at me, but so I'm hungry. If you know, got some chicken, I'll take it. Folks, that was a great set. Let's say hello to Mr. Jake Labatz and hear his story. New record called Sunnyside. Nice to meet you, sir.
Good to meet you.
And I understand you're from the Chicago area. Is that your native home?
Not from the Chicago area, from right in the middle of the Skid Row of the north side of the city.
Okay.
Yeah.
And you dove into the blues pretty hardcore, not just as a fan, but as a practitioner, and sought out folks who could teach you a thing or two. And that's I went to college in Chicago and, you know, sort of partook of the blues scene, but it's quite something to imagine as a young guy starting to knock on doors and bug people and ask to sit up close and listen and watch. How did you approach it? What was the story?
Well, it was an interesting time and to be in Chicago. We had a place called Maxwell Street Market, which some people might be familiar with. It was the world's biggest open air, like a flea market, you could say. And it was famous because, for one thing, all the great blues musicians since the 1910s, 20s, played there. Pretty much anybody you could name, you know, played on Maxwell Street. And when I was a kid, they still had some old tenements. For $5, somebody throw you out a wire so you could plug in your rig and play out there. And they had blues groups and gospel groups would play out there on Sunday mornings. And so I would go out there and listen to the people play out there. There was a guy named Maxwell Street Jimmy Davis who was like my hero. He was like the mayor of Maxwell Street. And I spent a lot of time with him, hanging out with him, playing with him. And then there was other people. I had records by them. I didn't even know they were still alive till I got old enough to kind of sneak into bars, you know. And there was a guy named Honeyboy Edwards, David Honeyboy Edwards. And I went to sneak into a place when I was 16, 17 and started to make friends with him, hang out at his house. Homesick James, another guy, pre-war era, guy that played through the 50s and 60s. So,
what do you think attracted you? What was turning you on about it?
It's what that music really met my internal landscape, I think. When I was I was one of those weird, sad kids who liked to hang out and listen to records over and over again. And I'd go to the library and do that, and I'd, you know, do it at home. And I just got to really love blues. My mom, who I didn't know very well, she played guitar, it turns out, and she was also played blues, and her brother, my uncle, played fingerstyle blues. Hmm. So maybe something passed through in utero.
Okay.
Yeah.
And did you start gigging as soon as you could? Did you look for opportunities to play and figure this is going to be my living?
No, man. I just thought, never even crossed my mind that I might play music for a living.
Wow.
I dropped out of high school, did construction work, did boiler making, and, you know, I wrote obituaries for a newspaper. I worked in factories. I just did whatever kind of job I could get. I never thought I'd play music, but I knew there had to be an easier way to turn a buck than what I was doing. Okay. And I like music. And so eventually I thought, well, maybe I could get this up on its legs a little bit. So I started playing in the subway in Chicago and playing out on the street and, eventually playing in clubs, opening up for those guys.
Chicago, a busking-friendly city? Is it a place that made it relatively easy? It's not easy anywhere, but...
It might be better now. It was kind of just at the behest of whoever was the law that came around and saw you playing, what they wanted to do with
you.
But in the 80s, they passed a thing where you had to have a vendor's license or something. But even that wouldn't guarantee you could play outside. So It wasn't always so friendly.
And also not always very temperate either in Chicago, Illinois. A lot of months of the year, it's pretty much out to be playing outdoors. But
the people really liked it. I think the people, and then I'd see all these blues musicians passing through Detroit Junior and different, all kinds of great musicians would come through the subway on their way to dialysis or wherever they were going, old guys. They were sick, you know.
And they'd had the blues till you've gone through that, folks.
And it was a cool place to meet people. And it's a good way to get your chops up, young guitar pickers.
How to get attention.
Man,
there's a whole lot we could ask about. You've moved to Nashville recently, or how recently would you make your way to?
Just last year.
Okay. Quick version of what attracted you and how it's working out, what you're finding here that you maybe hadn't had in any other music towns?
You know, I came here with my girlfriend, Miss Annika, who's back there someplace, and she was on tour with me doing this tattoo tour where I play at tattoo shops. And we came here for 3 days, and everything that could go right went right.
Oh, I see.
It's just a strange situation. I don't know, I got a house to rent, and I got an agent to work with for acting, and met some great people, and it's like, wow, we're walking around the park and it's beautiful and people are friendly. And I'm like, man, let's get out of Brooklyn. Can we get out of the big city for a while? So we came here. We've been loving it. We're still, trying to find a way around.
Going to shoot that tape right over to the Chamber of Commerce. What an endorsement. That's hopefully the magic lasts. And welcome. I do want to ask you one question about Sunnyside. This record is fantastic, but you did something I've never seen anybody do. You took a track from your prior record, reconfigured it, re-recorded it, and made it a title track of this new one. What is so powerful about that song for you that led you to do that?
Well, the funny story with that song is that that is the original version that's on the new record.
Oh,
we started making this record 6 years ago. This is High Style Records, Jimmy Sutton. He's bass player for J.D. McPherson, and he also produced J.D. and produced Pokey Lafarge. And he was just getting his label kind of going with that first J.D. record. And so he was a one-man operation. It was going real slow, and I just thought, man, this is going too slow for me. I'm going to go make my own record. I'll talk to you later. Okay. But that version haunted me. I thought it was really good, and I said, hey, man, maybe we should put that out as a single, 45. He said, let's come back and make a record. So we finally finished it up. That's the story.
Great. That's clear. Well, can't endorse the record enough. Go get you one over there, and we'll see you back here again. It's been too long. I'm glad you're finally here.
Hey,
Jake Labatz, folks.
Thanks, Craig.
Yeah.
Thank you.
Before we move on with the music, we have to sing about some chili. We have some guests in the house. Folks, introduce yourselves and sing us a song.
When I get home from work, I grab me a can. I pull the tab and let the fun begin. It'd be more fun. You invite your friends, Vietti chili, yeah. So get a little chili on your shirt and hands. Girls love guys with Vietti cans. They're waiting for you right now in the grocery store. It's better than your mama's recipe. Give her a bite and she'll agree that dinner time won't be same anymore. Vietti chili.
Wow. You know, that is so emotionally impactful. It brings a tear to your eye. You sort of don't expect to get, you think it's just a chili commercial, but it's not just a chili commercial, okay? It's all of us and everything that we do and believe. I want to tell you about a band here, folks. A band that calls to mind the ancient trail from Nashville to Natchez, a pathway for animals and settlers and traders and tourists and probably penguins soon. When you travel in the Natchez Trace, you might hear distant echoes of cosmic southern funk. Because that's what these guys do. Please welcome the Natchez Tracers.
Yeah.
is like trying to put a leash on a rainbow. And it's where the clouds and sun come together.
Just a small town girl, wishing on the banks, letting all your cares go.
A thrown stone in the water still goes to the bottom. Understanding you is like a being inside a tornado. Which way that you go depends on the weather.
Just a country girl rocking on the banks, letting all your cares go.
Take off all your clothes and fears if you got them.
Roll on by, don't ascend one.
Good evening, everybody, here in beautiful Franklin. And out there in Radio Land, wherever you're listening. The song's about needing to change. There's a darkness in your heart where the light can't go. Who you are and who you want to be. Your insecurities form your realities. When there's a darkness in your heart where the light can't go. There's a darkness in your heart where the light can't go. There's a darkness in your heart where the light can't go. You can't be clear when black is all you see. Your starry misery won't find no company. When there's a darkness in your heart where the light can't go. There's a darkness in your heart. But the light can't go. Last year, I want you to hold me. To everyone is clear, moved by every pain and fear. And a darkness in your heart where the light can't go. And a darkness in your heart where the light can't go. You lash out at the ones that hold you dear. To everyone is clear, you're ruled by envy, pain, and fear. And a darkness in your heart where the light can't go. And a darkness in your heart where the light can't go. With the darkness in your heart, where the light can't go. With the darkness in your heart, where the light can't go. With the darkness in your heart, where the light can't go. With the darkness in your heart, where the light can't go. With the light, can I go?
We're going to take it down a notch.
This is a happy little tune about that I wrote after losing my cousin and my dad in a couple months apart about 3 years ago.
If I could see you in my dreams,
If I could see you then, you'd tell me one more time. It's gonna be okay. It's gonna be okay. It's gonna be okay. It's gonna be okay.
Time for, I guess, two more. We're the Natchez Tracers from right here in Middle Tennessee. Yeah, yeah. Hometown heroes, or at least we like to think of ourselves as such. The heroes part is questionable, I believe. But maybe there's some heroes on the ice somewhere up north today. We appreciate all of y'all out here in Liberty Hall, in the factory, for choosing to spend your evening with us. And not watching all your phones about how the Predators are doing up there. So we appreciate it. We're having a lot of fun. Thank y'all so much. And feel free to dance on these last two if you get the inclination. You guys dance, we dance a little more too.
Maybe they never do, maybe never will, and maybe it's just how I'm feeling today. I've trusted, there's no sign. Can't reverberate my great desire to turn it down. Bring it pound for pound and start it over in another way. I'm not naive to think I can change anyone or anything when I need it. The biggest change. Me. When I'm feeling down like a nobody, that's when I'll try to remember that everyone is a somebody to someone somewhere. Well, I'm cashed out, I'm sputtered down. Maybe I'm too far in on this to turn it down. Bring it pound for pound, start it over in another way. Well, I've called out. There's no sound that can reverberate this great desire to turn it down. Bring it pound for pound, start it over in another way. I'm not naive to think I can change anyone or anything when I need it. The biggest change still in me. When I'm feeling down like a nobody, that's what I've tried to remember. Everyone is a somebody to someone somewhere, even me. Somebody to someone somewhere. Everyone is a somebody to someone somewhere. We are all somebody to someone somewhere.
Well, I'm busted, I'm beaten down. No one cares what I think or say. Maybe they never do, maybe never will. Maybe it's just how I'm feeling today.
New songs are always... Thanks so much for Music City Roots having us tonight and all the wonderful crew.
Absolutely.
Everybody give a hand for the crew. Yeah. Ah. Yeah. All right. We like to tune because we care. And because it sounds better, frankly. All right. A song called Started Feeling Better.
I still get our bills. The news lady says there's a robot coming. Be my job it takes. The real hornswoggle's already on the books. I saw what the boss man makes. I never knew how bad I felt till I started. Till I started feeling better. Till I started feeling better. Till I started feeling. I never knew how bad I felt till I started. Till I started feeling better. Well, there's a lure of secret knowledge inside. Surprise when you lift up the rug and learn the ones you sought out on the internet to help bring in the truth. With your snake oil charlatans of a new breed pulling the con on you. I never knew how bad I felt till I started. Till I started feeling better. Till I started feeling.
Till I
passed out and feeling better. Till I started feeling better. Till I started feeling better. Till I started feeling.
Natchez Tracers, folks. Man. A spiraling jam of epic spiritual proportion there.
Say what?
I said that was a spiraling jam of epic spiritual proportions.
I just wondered if you could say it twice.
Yeah, I can. I could say it another time, but I don't want to say it. I want to properly introduce you. Folks, you may not know. You know he's a Hall of Fame broadcaster, and you know he does the best station IDs in the business, right? Yeah.
I try. Thank you.
You may not know that he has been patiently and steadfastly dodging these near constant accusations of improper collusion with the Russians lately.
That's
and
right.
He's just holding up great under fire.
I had a white Russian like 10 years ago. That's it.
You and Harlan Howard.
And
probably.
I didn't like it, really.
Hey, ladies and gentlemen, that's Keith Bilbrey.
All right. Thank you, Peter Cooper. You're listening to Roots Radio, 89.5 WMOT, Murfreesboro, Nashville, Franklin, the pride of Middle Tennessee State. 100,000 watts of pure Americana. So happy to be live on the air with our partners at WMOT, part of MTSU's College of Media and Entertainment. Please remember to support public radio. Find your way to WMOT.org. Press the donate button. For as little as 10 bucks a month, you can go a long way, and it can get you invited to our private member shows. MCI receives support from Acceptance Auto Insurance for our nationwide PBS television series, and also brings you the Acceptance Morning Ride with our own, what is that guy's name? Walker. Oh, yeah, John Walker. Weekdays, I swear on this page it says Keith Walker. It kind of threw me. Weekdays from 6 to 9 a.m. on WMOT Roots Radio. Acceptance takes pride in delivering auto insurance, even to folks who've had some, well, let's say, challenges with their auto insurance. Based right here in Nashville, doing business all across the country. Wherever your song takes you, Acceptance has you covered. Learn more at acceptance.com. Your terms accepted. Kind of like Craig Havokhurst. We just accept him on his own terms. There's no way
glad
else.
Glad of
do.
That, Keith. That's why I feel so warm and family like
right.
around here. I appreciate you.
You're our buddy.
All right. Well, that was a rousing set of good music. And let's thank these guys one more time. From the Natchez Tracers, Josh Womack and Lewis Stubbs. You you brought your partisans tonight. You got some fans and friends in the area. That's great. Thank you for coming, for making some noise in our radio broadcast.
Well, it helps when we all live within a 20-mile radius of the venue.
Yeah, okay, that's cool. Helpful. Well, let's talk about that. Let's talk about roots in the area. I love your name. I love that you tapped into this a really important part of the area's history and kind of a route down to the south. You even passed through Muscle Shoals practically when you take the Natchez Trace. So, like, what led you? You know, are you all native Tennesseans?
Three of the four core of us are native Nashvillians. Yeah. Lewis and I grew up. We've known each other since middle school. He went to elementary school with my wife and our drummer. Okay. We found Brad through his record collection on the internet. It was just so schizophrenic, like our music taste,
okay.
that we found him and we lucked out. He's from upper Illinois, Pekin area. And Derek Pell is also native, fiddle player, and he's a halftime tracer.
Okay.
We get him. We just came out with a stint throughout the Southeast with him on board with us. And if we could have him all the time, we probably would, but he's a busy man.
Okay, fair enough. How do you feel like what you were doing with this band when it came together was a culmination or a shift from where you had been? When a band comes together and you're like, this is working, this is what we want to do, this is what we want to be, and set out life together, kind of give us a little sketch of what the shift was.
Well, that's a good one. I pretty much have always played the same kind of, you know, the same southern roots that, you know, it's country, blues, rock and roll, boogie, funk, all of its American roots kind of music. Josh and I kind of reconnected, two or three years back and started working and writing songs together and could sing together well, and we worked well writing the songs. And, you know, he's been playing around town for years and years. I've been playing around town for years. I played in a band called Highwater. We actually played Music City Roots back in 2011.
But,
that Welcome was kind back. Of a reunion thing. So it's, you know, this band gives me a bigger chance to sing, and we just work really well together. But it's just, we all have day jobs and, you know, scratching to make records and play on the weekends. And it's just, I'm just thrilled that we still get to do it, you know, still get to play music. So
if there's a home base for your gigs that, you know, feel like you grew up there, where is that?
Nashville would be a home base, but I tell you the difference. Nashville has changed so much in 25 years that I've been playing music. It's truly unbelievable how different it is. I mean, the scene is so much bigger. But Franklin kind of is where we kind of sort of Kimbrose is. They gave us
after every week.
That's definitely would be our home away from home for sure.
And you said songwriting, and that is kind of the key, isn't it? That's what takes a band and gives you the leaping off point to be your own thing. Talk about, you know, what you think you've learned about songwriting over the years and why you think it worked with you guys.
Well, I've always been in original bands, so much to the point that I never learned a lot of covers. So I probably should have learned more.
Okay.
But Josh and I both probably wouldn't be satisfied playing in cover bands, you know, fulfilled. So it's just kind of, I do it because I can't not do it that way.
Okay.
So, and it works well with Josh. So.
And to add to what he said, you know, Natchez Tracer is kind of like the band we were never mature enough to have in our 20s. And now later we've learned a lot more.
Yeah.
You know, it's the band you always dream of, but, you know, it's a lot of give and take. We're democratic about the way we go about things. Ideas come from
Electoral College, actually.
Electoral College. We're working on getting rid of that, the Electoral College. But ultimately, we as far as influences, I mean, Lewis and I have some J.J. Cale, the band, Little Feet, are definitely shared interest. And then the classic American groove bands, you know, the Grateful Dead, and there's stuff in there, too. And, really the song leads, but we like to stretch and try unconventional things occasionally.
How did you commemorate the passing of Brother Greg Allman this week?
Well, you know, we found out we were at a barbecue festival in Augusta on Saturday, and about 10 minutes before we went on stage, 10 or 15 minutes, they told us Greg passed. And we did a version of a Don't Keep Me Wondering, which is a great Greg vocal performance. So I was a little nervous, you know, in front of, there was at that point 5,000-7,000 people of stepping out and doing that. But we felt like we gave it the heart and the justice of, you know, we've lost a lot of great, great influences over the past year and a half. And, you know, we're still working on trying to create new art and art's living. And there's great music being made all the time. everywhere. It's never too late to get novel, new experiences as you get older.
Well, that's true. And in Nashville right now, the sheer supply, the tonnage of quality of not just the artists, but excellent artists, is both inspiring and intimidating, you know, and it's almost a problem. It's so enriching right now.
Well, there's so much here, and there's so much to do all the time. I mean, when you get out of town, we just had a little weekend run, and it was great to, like, remind yourself that people like hearing live music, you know. It's just that there's so much great talent here, and everybody's just so, you know, just bombarded all the time. We're just happy people show up and listen to us crank out our original songs and occasionally covers and do our thing, and, you know, it's they grow with us as we go on. So
fantastic. It's great to meet you guys. Natchez Traces, everybody. Thanks, Josh. Thanks, Lewis. On we go with the music. Center Ice is Senator Peter Cooper.
Yes. Thank you, Craig Havighurst. And I do want to introduce this fine next band. I do want to give you a little update, though. Towards the end of the first period, the Predators were actually able to pin the Penguins back in their own end zone for a safety. So it is now 15-3 Predators. How about that? That's pretty good. Way to go. If we finish the next two periods like that, it'll be like 45-9. That's a darn good hockey outcome. Hey, folks, formed in 2011, it only took this band from Florida a few short years to break out with a 2014 album, In Tongues. They tore it up on the festival circuit and on the TV circuit. They did that on the strength of epic melodies and thoughtful instrumentation, and we are excited that they've swung by Roots for a set tonight. Ladies and gentlemen, Roadkill Ghost Choir.
The sounds we make erase Our first time in Franklin. Thanks for being here. We're going to play a new one for you. One, two, three, four. I can draw the line between my friends and enemies. You say the future's open wide, forget my destiny. And I got nowhere to go, I'm going nowhere. I got nowhere to go, I'm going nowhere. I am a cynic, sad man who drift in my mind. Shit my skeet in the wind, art house suicide. I got no one to hold, I got no one. I got no one to hold, I got no one. Yeah, 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 yeah. I record my memory.
All of them. This is a song from our very first EP. And we hope you guys like this one. That's all I got to say about that. This one's called Beggar's Guild.
Put it on to get off real quick on the bottom of the pile. I'm feeling sick. And it never crossed my mind that my baby left, no, to keep me in the beggar's guild. So I sleep all day and I dream. I used to know, if I know I'm far away from the sea. fear no one but you. Don't cry, no, no. Only to tell the truth. No.
Here's a song called Sad Magic.
In the morning, yeah, I'm looking down, babe, on the freaks in the lower labs of the air. I'm able, yeah, body to laugh, and I cut my teeth on compromise. Get the fire, come on, homie, yeah, never drown in my own life. Now you see me.
Way too kind, thank you.
Use
pocket full of dirt, a ton of joke. Or the ghost in the mirror just as time is speeding up. Losing your race, my pledge, just a slave. The darkness of my last flashlight. Twins, mirrored like with the dread blood cast. But what care for the company, man?
Roadkill Ghost Choir. Thanks, guys. Man. Keith Bilbrey.
How about that steel guitar, huh?
I'm a fan of a steel guitar.
Me too. You know? I love that.
Lloyd Green is one of my good friends and a great pedal steel
name
player.
Dropper,
but
name
he doesn't
dropper.
Have stuff, you know, kind of written on his steel guitar like that. That's super
well,
cool.
He's even got a bunny rabbit.
He ain't got
here.
A yellow bar either. Yeah.
You so see that Lloyd, little bunny Lloyd's rabbit?
One, I like the bunny to step rabbit. It up.
What's the bunny rabbit's name?
It doesn't have a name.
Oh, okay. That's Lloyd. That's Lloyd.
It's Lloyd. There you go. Hey, Key, I should give it just a quick update.
Oh, let's hear it. Yeah.
Yeah, the Preds actually...
Wait a minute. Let me do a disclaimer. The score you're about to hear is probably made up in his mind.
Oh,
it does not
no.
reflect the actual
no,
score
I've,
of the Predators
I've been assiduously
okay.
following this when I wasn't watching and listening to Roadkill Ghost Choir. It was really exciting. The Preds... scored a run, drove home, hit a double, and it drove home a runner from first base. There was a play at the plate, but they got it going on. So now it is actually 16-3. Preds.
Did they get the extra point attempt?
Yeah, they're lining up for that right
the
now.
Kicker,
so
yep.
It could be 17 soon.
I don't know what he's watching, but anyway. Okay, thank you very much for that update, Peter.
You got it. Anytime, Keith.
Yeah, anytime, yeah.
Now back to you.
Yeah, okay. Music City Roots receives support for this broadcast from businesses that are leaders in our community, like Ascend Federal Credit Union, the preferred credit union of MTSU Athletics. Ascend offers convenient online account access, bill payment, and statements with an app to access your accounts and check them on the go. Visit AscendFCU.org to register for e-services from Ascend, Ascend Federal Credit Union, raising possibilities. Ascend's federally insured by the NCUA. Membership is limited. All right, let's go back to the chat room, and there's Craig Havoc-Hurst with a whole nother update of the Predators.
Right. No, I can't top Peters. Yeah. I know nothing more than he does. But hey, say thanks one more time for Roadkill Ghost Choir, Andrew and Zach from the band right here. Tremendous stuff. Florida-based, right? Still in your home base?
No, we live in Athens, Georgia now.
Moved to Athens.
Yeah.
There's a music scene for you.
Oh, it's awesome. Yeah.
But it was Florida was where you guys came up and formed.
Yep. Yeah.
Now there's three brothers in the band, right?
Yeah, me, him, and the drummer.
Okay.
Yeah.
And is it? That sounds like one kind of easy to tell story. Three brothers form a band. But when you guys decided to do this, had there been other stabs at other different kinds of things? Had you grown up playing music, you know, from this height together? Or what led to this?
Yeah, I think he can give the better story of how it all started.
All right.
Yeah, I mean, me and my brothers have always played music, but strangely never together until we started Roadkill. I was just kind of doing music on my own, and him and Max, the drummer, were doing their own kind of thing. And I got asked to play a show, like a solo show, and I figured that'd be completely horrifying for not only myself, but everyone listening. So I got them to play with me, and I roped in our pedal steel player, Kiffy, and we just kind of started from there. And now we're playing shows together as brothers, but also as best friends after all these years.
Good stuff. See, that's beautiful. Were you of and part of a music scene that helped support this, or were you in a place that kind of didn't have one where what you were doing felt like filling a void?
Well, the place where we're originally from is called DeLand, Florida, and there's not much of a music scene, if anything, there. It's a lot of more like a coffee shop, singer songwriters, or just cover bands, bar band stuff. There wasn't much to cling on to, like, scene-wise, nothing like Nashville or where we moved to Athens.
Mm-hmm.
We just kind of just did our own thing for a little bit. Then we kind of found pockets outside of where we're from, like cities and stuff like that.
Did you guys run to try to find gigs out of town right away? Were you like, let's hit it hard?
Yeah.
Well, that's the striking thing, is that you guys date the band to 2011, and by 2014, you've got a very successful debut album and a whole lot of media appearances and big festivals. What do you think helped make that pivot and helped you get noticed? Was there a single moment, single performance, or somebody who went to bat for you?
Honestly, I think it was all based off our looks.
Yeah.
There was very little talent, as you all saw and heard on the radio. We're just gorgeous looking men, simple as that.
I want your take on that one.
I mean, he is right, but I think we got surrounded by a good group of people that helped kickstart us.
Yeah.
A booking agent who found us a manager, who found us a label, who found this, who found that. So we were lucky in that sense.
What was the label role? Who was that?
Wolfbomb, I guess, was the first. They weren't like a big label. We were like the second band they ever signed.
Okay.
And we weren't on there too long.
Still, it can lead to at least the CDs go out in the mail to writers, and at least, you know, you get maybe some punches at media and radio. So, all right. Did you find radio play? I mean, did this fit into the kind of arcade fiery sort of situation that was out there on radio?
No, not really.
Okay.
I think a little bit here and there.
I'd like to hear
certain
this on
pockets
the radio.
Okay. Of towns. Some college radio stuff, but
right.
No, we never had like a big single or anything like that. So,
what was Bonnaroo like in 2014?
Oh man, it was kind of a disaster.
I don't want to ask about. I don't want to dig up any bad memories, but
no. I remember we
it's
played
on your resume.
We played and like this guitar amp went down and the bass amp went down and the sound guy was like brushing his teeth And we were like, okay. But no, we had a great time. We got to see a lot of cool bands. So,
well, y'all are sounding really good, and I love the very arranged and full sound, a lot of texture. I love the kind of vintage synth, and that was the steel guitar part of the mix from the very get-go, because it's very central to the way the texture of the band.
Yeah, he's been in the band since the start, so yeah, that's always been a big part of it.
Great. I mean, do you guys sort of consciously think about, you know, how you want these layers? Because there's a lot of layers to work on. This is something that doesn't just kind of happen when you start to kind of pound away through chord changes.
Yeah, Andy does a lot.
Okay.
In his room.
Yeah, I mean, with having six people in a band like that, you have to consciously make decisions of who's doing what at all times. So that's a big thing when we sit down and we record. We make sure no one's, you know, stepping over this other guitar part, or like the, you know, everything works around the vocal melody or right. What have you. So yeah, it's a process that we make sure we don't just kind of explode, yeah, just right. Like nothing but noise. You know, we try to make it work.
Yeah, it builds to a particular place, and you want to know where you're going and where
exactly.
You're starting.
Yeah.
Uh-huh, uh-huh. Any formal music training in your background that would lead you there? Is this all intuition?
Oh no, I'm a complete disaster when it comes to music, but. No, I don't think so. I don't think anyone, other than our guitar player.
All right.
But yeah.
All right. Any plans right now? You said you were working on something to come out either later this year, early next year?
Yeah, we're putting out a new record, hopefully in September.
Oh, there we go. Yeah. Shoot. All right. Must be done then.
It is very done. It's been done for a long time.
Okay.
It's another story.
A little story there.
Maybe too long.
It's a hard life in
It'll
the music
be the
business,
book.
Isn't it?
Yeah.
Now, are you guys on just hitting the road all the time? Are you road dogs or
we
off and on?
We have been for a while. We kind of took it easy the last year and a half because we were recording and getting all that stuff ready. Yeah. But we're about to hit the road coming, I think, in June, and then a bigger tour in, I think, October.
In the fall.
Yeah, after
right.
The record's out.
I certainly wish you guys well. Everybody ready in the center stage? I can't tell. Am I getting a clue that the... am I getting the thumbs up? Peter, everybody ready to go?
Yeah.
Okay, great.
We're just hanging
folks,
out.
One more time for Roadkill Ghost Choir. You guys are a fine band. I love it. Thanks for being part of our show. Best of luck. All right, center stage, Peter Cooper.
Okay, I'm sorry to inform you that the Predators actually just balked in. They balked in a run a moment ago, so it's now it's 16-4. Folks, not many musicians can get credit for fundamentally altering a region's music scene or changing the trajectory of a genre of music. A lot of musicians can't even spell trajectory. But this guy can. As a member of Yonder Mountain String Band, he stretched bluegrass in new and far-reaching directions. Yeah, that's wooable. As a soloist, he has been able to make a mark as a songwriter and a collaborator. We are excited to welcome him to Roots for the very first time with his fine band, the Jeff Austin Band.
Good way to explain what I did to the question that rattled suburban refrain. Time ain't tight until you throw it away. Face pale white in convenience store lights. I'm beginning to believe surroundings somehow recognize my schemes. Time ain't tight until you throw it away. Face pale white in convenience store lights.
Rundown's a good way to explain what I did to the question that rattled suburban refrain. Time ain't tight until you throw it away. Face pale white, inconvenient store lights.
Trip trying to follow someone else's dreams. Look, that you know goes splitting at the seams. Love my little baby, love my machine. Left before a fella that she hardly ever seen. I'm on a death trip, a baby. I'm on a death trip, baby. I'm on a death trip, a baby. I'm on a death trip, baby. Oh, my world tumbled down when the leaves begin to fall. Picked up all the dresses and the pictures in the hall. Left the car running, standing at the shopping mall. Now the phone don't ring. Staring at the wall, I'm on a death trip, a baby. I'm on a death trip, baby. I'm on a death trip, but baby, I'm on a death trip. Towel total bigger on my bed to go. Teachers said my world was burning down. Daddy said he didn't want to see my face around. Police pulled me over on the furthest edge of town. Lawyers and the deacons do attended by the pound. I'm on a death trip, a baby. I'm on a death trip, baby. I'm on a death trip, a baby. I'm on a doo-dee-dee-dee desert roll. I'm taking all the down the way.
troubled mind. I love her in the morning and I kiss her all the time. Yeah, I come home from work and I can see my baby shine. But the boss man, that old boss man, tried to keep me working overtime. Oh, that boss man, he tried to keep me working overtime all the time until the said now. And if the car won't start, if she can't get going right, she can just move, 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 move just a little bit slow. Right in bed, get up and right in my.
Play one more for you. Thank you. green mile. Max Johnson, Mike Robinson, thank you so much.
How about that Jeff Austin band? Wow. Superb. Man, if that's if that's laryngitis, somebody was saying this backstage, like, I want some.
I met a lightning bolt in the alley.
That is, man, did you go see Dr. Snap or something in between somebody else's set?
Pound on the floor, you pull it up from the earth, and it goes in your throat and it makes it all work.
Gosh.
Defiance of the vocal gods is what you've just witnessed, ladies and gentlemen. And tomorrow, you will pay. You will pay, my friend.
Wow.
You'll be taken down. Thanks for joining us here tonight on Music City Roots, folks. Glad to have you in the audience. Glad to have you listening at home. You have been listening, of course, on 89.5 WMOT, Murfreesboro, Nashville, Franklin. Roots Radio, we call it. And we hope you'll listen all week long, and we hope you'll consider hitting that donate button and being part of listener-supported public radio. I meant to say welcome earlier tonight. I hope some of you are still here to our two groups who are visiting. Contiki Tours is here, mostly from Australia.
Yeah!
You are still here. Thank you for sticking around to the end. Great to have you in Nashville, Tennessee. Also from overseas in the sister city of Bad Soden, the German delegation. If they are still here, they may have... Well, they just arrived this afternoon. They are dead set jet lagged, so I understand. But we're glad to have each and every one of you here. And let's say thanks once again. Our artists tonight were Jake Labatz, the Natchez Tracers, Roadkill Ghost Choir, and the Jeff Austin Band. One big round of applause. Yeah. Everybody threw down. Blackstone Brewery lineup for next week. We were here another Wednesday, of course. And we're going to be hearing from our buddy John Bird is back on Music City Roots. I know you love some John Bird, and so do I.
Yeah.
Rock and roll.
Amen.
Yeah. That was the John Bird sound effect. Can I get a Beppe Gambetta sound effect? Nothing. He's a phenomenal flat pick guitar player from Italy. He's Italy's greatest bluegrass guitarist. And Beppe is great. The Wooks are here for what I believe is a debut performance. And returning to Music City Roots, Rhonda Vincent with her duet partner, Daryl Singletary.
Oh, yeah.
So if you are into some hard country and bluegrass, you can't beat Rhonda and Daryl. And I know Keith Bilbrey knows about that.
Oh, yeah, it's a great album.
Yeah.
I worked with them yesterday on
television. They sing those old George Jones, Melba Montgomery duets.
I don't know whether Mike Johnson's going to be with them or not. He was with us on the TV show, and I'm still hurting from some of those licks he played, man.
Yeah.
It was tough.
Well, you had a good time, Keith?
I've had a great time.
I have, too.
Me too, Harold. So is it my turn?
It's your turn with the jam.
Tell me about that
sweet, sticky, beautiful Nashville jam.
I got two handfuls of jam here. Music City Roots, a production of Hang Dye Media, and we've got some strawberry jam and some raspberry jam. And I want to thank the Nashville Jam Company for sponsoring this final segment we lovingly call the Nashville Jam. These jams are all natural, made right here locally with love, also available at your local grocer or specialty market. Once again, let's welcome to center stage our host for tonight, filling in for Jim Lauderdale, filling some mighty big shoes, and let me tell you, he did a mighty fine job, Mr. Peter Cooper!
He's our goalie.
Thank you. Thank you, Mr. Bilbrey. Hey, man, we're gonna do this and send it out to one of the great soul singers that any of us ever heard, and a soulful writer as well, Greg Allman, in memory of Greg Allman.
Go ahead, Jeff Austin Band. Set us a tempo.
I gotta run to keep from hiding, and I'm bound to keep on riding. I got one more silver dollar. I'm not gonna let them catch me, no, I'm not gonna let them catch the midnight rider.
hard of carry. Some old bed I'll soon be sharing. And I've got one more silver dollar. But I'm not gonna let them catch me, no. I'm not gonna let them catch the midnight rider.
This is a production of Hang Dye Media. The jam continues tonight at Kimbrough's Pickin' Parlor in Franklin. Stop by for a nightcap, a snack, and bring your instruments. We're all going there now for a Blackstone beer and a song or two. I'm Keith Bilbrey, and from the edge of Music City, good night, everybody.